Hello, in this video, I'll show you how I set up and add all the controls to a Home Assistant dashboard for my motion sensing lights. I'm also sharing the full code so you can do it too. The setup we have at the moment is I've got a on-off basic, which is running ESPHome, obviously. The relay on that is switching this power supply on and off, which is a 12-volt power supply. That 12-volt power supply goes directly to the LED strip, and I've just put a diffuser over here to stop the camera being blown out. Out of the sign-off basic, I'm using three GPIO pins for RGB and a 0 volts, obviously. That goes onto a little MOSFET board, and the MOSFET board is powering these LEDs. In Home Assistant, on my control panel, I've got my motion sensing lights on a card. The one we're using here is table light. That's this setup here. So let's turn this light down a little bit so we can see what's going on. On the dashboard, we have two items. We have the light itself and its controls. Here I can turn the light on and off just by clicking it. And we can see that's come on at the right color. The color here on the outside is the color that the light will come on. So when it's off, you can see what color it's gonna be. That color is set by these red, green, and blue sliders. So as you can see, I can adjust it. Like so, and if I turn the light on now, it will now come on to those colors. The main benefit of this is that I can adjust the color of the light. I can see what the color of the light is without having to go to a light itself, turn it on, change the color, set the brightness, etc. That's all done here, so I can see what color the lights will come on. Next up is the brightness. Now this won't make any difference to this color here, but if I turn this right up and turn the light back on, you can see that that brightness has now gone up. All these sliders are dynamic, so that I can adjust the brightness and the color of the light on the fly, and you can see that the light updates. So we'll just turn that down a little bit. That's a bit too much. The last thing that these timer lights have is a timer. Now normally this is set to minutes, but I've set this to 4 seconds for the demo so we don't have to wait too long. So I can turn the light off. Whether the timer is used or not is dictated by this enable button. And this can be set up with an automation elsewhere in Home Assistant so that the timer light only works at night, say, or a specific time of the day. And to save me waving my arms about like an idiot, I've got a fake motion sensor which is controlling this particular light. So if I trigger this, you see the lights come on, it will wait for the 4 seconds, and turn itself off again. So again, I can adjust the color of the light. So let's make it a purpley color. So this will be what the light comes on when the motion sensing is triggered again. So there you go, it's now purple. Right, that's the demo done. Let me show you how I did it. As always, I try and put as much as possible on my ESPHome devices. So let's look at the code for this on-off basic. As always, I'm using substitutions. We can see here, the first part I've given it a name. That's the name for the entities. Next up, we have the motion sensor. Now, this is a motion sensor in Home Assistant. And like I say, I've made a fake one, and that's an input Boolean. For your version, this will be the entity of the motion sensor that you want to use for your particular light. Then we've got the standard boilerplate for ESPHome for the Wi-Fi. Obviously, I'm using secrets. The only difference here is the restore from flash. This ensures that all these sliders and the settings of that light get remembered between reboots. Next up, we've got the number component. This I'm using for the sliders. So I've got 5 here for the RGB, the brightness and the timeout. And they all come in here. So we've got the reds, the green, the blue, the brightness and the timer. And for the RGB, each one of these RGB channels goes from 0 to 255 brightness. So I've used that in this slider. For the brightness, that's obviously 0 to 100%. And finally, the timer. You can change this timer if you need a longer interval of the light being on before it turns itself off. Next up is the binary sensor. This is the sensor that comes in from Home Assistant. And we're using the substitution here. So that reads what's coming in up here in the motion sensor substitution. So that comes in here. I'm doing an internal true. That way ESPHome doesn't report this back to Home Assistant. It uses the condition to see, first of all, if the light is off. As I say, the motion sensor won't do anything if the light has been manually turned on. So you can come into a room, turn the light on, and it won't time out for you. Next up, I have another binary sensor. This controls the relay on our setup, and that's governed by whether the LEDs are on or off. If they're on, turns the relay on. If it's off, turns the relay off. And that relay is a standard on-off basic GPIO 12. Next, we have the enable switch. That's this thing here. And that's part of the script which enables the timer to be run or not. Finally, the script itself. So first of all, we'll turn the light on. RGB mode for the lights. The RGB color is the sliders divided by 255. Now, for some reason, this set RGB is 0 to 100%. The RGB values are 0 to 255 brightness. So yeah, go figure. And these are the IDs of our three sliders for the RGB. Then we have the value or the state of the brightness slider. And we're dividing that by 100 because the brightness in this setup is 0 to 1, not 0 to 100. The next part of the script is the timeout. Now I've done a restart here. Every time the motion is sensed, it restarts this timer. So I had this set to 4 seconds in the demo. If I was to re-trigger that within 4 seconds, it would restart the timer again. And so we'll keep the light on when there's continuous motion. And then finally on this is the light itself. The corresponding GPIO pins for the RGB channels coming out of that Sonoff Basic and the status LED of the Sonoff Basic itself. All you need to do is obviously make sure your name's the same, give it a name for all these to come in. These do come in as number, which is the slider, table, which is the name we've given the substitution, and then each one of the RGB comes in as underscore R, G and B, brightness, that comes in as brightness, and timer, again, comes in with a number, table, and then this one's called off time. Obviously the light itself comes in as substitution name, again, table, lights. For the RGB on a Sonoff Basic, I've done a video on how to do that, and you'll find that video up here in the corner. The pins and the wiring is exactly the same, so if you have made one of those, or you want to make one of these, follow that video for the hardware, but use this code to flash it or reflash it if you've already made one. Let's look at what comes in from that Sonoff Basic now. So we go to Devices and Services, Devices, we'll find the Lights section, and we'll look at Light Table, which is what I've called mine. So here you can see those entities and the relevant names that they were called in ESPHome. And here is that light entity that you have to turn on to change the brightness. All of those are now in Home Assistant. So let's look at the panel. So we go to Edit Dashboard. We'll have a look at the code for this first button. Each one of these motion sensing lights has two items in the dashboard. We have the light itself. That's just a standard custom button card. Next up, we have just an entities card. And if I show the code, we can see it a little bit easier. So this is all those entities that I've just shown coming in devices. And again, it's just a list of entities. And at each one of these, I've added a name so I can customize the name. So each one of these is nice and short. So for the button itself, as always, I've done a bit of code. As I've shown in previous tutorials, I do a dynamic name, and for the background, which is the background of this button that shows the colors, again, a bit of custom code. Now I'll give you the code for this, and as always, the only thing you need to change is the entity for your device. So that's the button done. For the entities, if we look at the code, all this needs to be changed. What I'm gonna do as a quick demo, we'll go to my strip light here. And again, we've got strip lights here. Everything else is the same. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna change that to table. And you can see this is now updated. The color's been replicated. That's the entity. And if we look down here, this won't change it now because we haven't updated the entities. So if we go back to here, go to number 2, which is our second lot here. We go to the entities. Now, the easiest way to change this, if we go to the code editor, just make this wider. What we want to do is change the word strip on each one of these RGB, brightness and timer to table. So these entities are now controlling that. The easiest way to do that is if we do control F, we got a find and replace. I'm just going to copy strip out of there, put it in there. And in here, I'm going to type in table. We'll do a replace all. And you can see that all the strip has been changed to table now. If we save that, now we've got the RGB and this will control both of these now. So just grab the code, adjust it to whatever you've called your entity and you're done. On the GitHub page, I'll give you the code for both the button and the entities. Now, I've got this in a vertical stack. So I've got a horizontal stack with vertical stacks in it. So if we go to number 2, this is the one I want to change back. Here we can see we've got table lights again. So number 1 is table lights. Number 2 is table lights. And that's the custom button card at the top here. Part 2 of that stack is the entities. So what we can do is we go to the first one again. If I hit this code editor here with 2 selected, which is this column, you can see that it's brought up the entire vertical stack that these two buttons are in. So custom button card at the top, the first one in our list under cards. The second card is an entities card, and that's these things here. If you keep the naming convention, you can just simply copy this whole code, and I'm going to change this back to what it was, which is strip light. So we'll click in the window, we'll do control F again, we'll just scroll down. This is table. And I wanted to change it back to strip. So I'll do replace all. You might have seen that update. And there we go. We've now got our strip light. And if we save that, these are now the entities for that strip light. So I'm just going to put that back to my default color that I have that on, and we'll close that down. Well, I hope this video was helpful for your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I love you. Bye-bye.